In this lecture, we are going to discuss the previous gate questions from the Z-transfor, right? So this, from the Z-transfor, minimum in the gate exam will get 1 to 3 marks, right? So in 2016, set 1, we got 1 more question, set 3, we got 3 marks. But unfortunately, this is about gate 2016. In gate 2017, there is no question from the Z-transfor. So no question from the Z-transfor. We got a question from the discrete time Fourier transform. Now in the gate 2018, we may expect from the Z-transfor. So this is the gate 2016 for 1 mark. See, given x of n is given like this, delta n minus 3 plus 2 into delta n minus 5 has Z transform x of z. Now the relation is given like this: if y of z is equal to x of minus z is the Z transform of another signal, then we need a relationship between y of n and x of n. Now by looking this, don't conclude that y of n will become x of minus n, right? That is given like this, but we need to find the Z transform of this x of n, then we have to take the minus z, then we'll see it will become this or this etc. Now the x of n is given like this: delta n minus 3 plus 2 into delta n minus 5. Now we know that by the shifting property, this is x of z will become z power minus 3 plus 2 into z power minus 5. Now this is x of z, so but what is given? Y of z is equal to x of minus z. Now if in place of z, if I substitute minus z, so what it will become? Minus of z power minus 3 plus 2 into minus z power minus 5. So 3 and 5 are odd numbers, so what we will get? We will get minus of z power minus 3 minus of 2 into z power minus 5. Now what we got? X of z power minus 3 plus 2 into z power minus 5. So if I take minus common, this will become z power minus 3 plus 2 into z power minus 5. So what is this? X of z. So therefore y of z is equal to minus of x of z, not x of minus z, right? That means if I take a what you call inverse z transform, this will become y of n is equal to minus of x of z, right? So what is the option? So this is not correct, this is not correct, this is not correct. So the option B is the correct one. So y of n is equal to minus of x of n. Now we'll see one more question, that is gate 2016. The ROC of the Z transform of a discrete time signal is represented by the shaded region in the Z plane. So the options are given and it is shaded. Then if the signal x of n is equal to 2.0 power mod n and n is here minus infinity to infinity, then the ROC of its Z transform is represented by. So from these options we need to identify that. So for this signal, what is the common ROC? So that is we need to do. Now once we take x of n is equal to 2 power mod n, now how to how to represent the signal? That is, for n less than 0, this will become 2 power minus n u of minus n minus 1, right? Then plus, for n greater than 0, this will become 2 power n u of n. This is x of n. Now we know that, so this will become what? 2 power minus n means 1 by 2 power n, and this is u of minus n minus 1 plus 2 power n u of n. Now if you find the Z transform, so x of z will become, see, this is the left sided sequence. That means, see, whenever this is a minus, we will get positive here. So if there is no minus, we will get minus 1 by 1 minus a, that is 1 by 2 z inverse, but the what ROC is the left sided, so mod z is less than 1 by 2. Plus this is a power n u of n, so 1 by 1 minus 2 into z inverse. And it is a right sided sequence, so we will get mod z is greater than 2. Now see, any common ROC exists, so something like this: 1 is at 1 by 2, 1 is at 2. So mod z is less than 2 means this one, and mod z is greater than 2 means this one. So is there any common ROC existing? So there is no common ROC. So from these options, this is less than 1 by 2, this is greater than 2, this is 0.5 to 2 in between. Here we mentioned does not exist, ROC does not exist. So what is the option? The correct option is does not exist. ROC does not exist. Option D is the right answer. Right. Now we'll see one more question. So it is also came in year 2016, depending on the ROC only. So x of n is given, that is a power n u of n plus b power n u of n. And the condition is given, the a and b are between 0 and 1, but the b is greater than the a, right? So that is the meaning. Now, how to find, so if I find the x of z, so it is the right side of sequences. So we will get 1 minus a into z inverse plus 1 minus b into z inverse. Now, what is the ROC? Mod z is greater than a. And this is mod z is greater than b, right? Now if we plot, see here, this is the condition. See which one is greater, a or b? B is the greater one. So here it is, anyway it is less than one, so no problem, it is a. And one more is b, which is greater than a. So this is the one. Now this is the one ROC, and one more ROC is greater than b. So greater than b means like this, right? So what is the common ROC? So common ROC is between mod z is greater than b. So mod z is greater than b. So this is the ROC of the given sequence, right? Now we'll solve this question. So this question came in GATE 2015. Suppose x of n is an absolutely summable discrete time signal. Now absolutely summable, remember this point, discrete time signal. And its Z transform is a rational function. Again, remember this point. It's a rational function with two poles and two zeros. And he mentioned the poles are at Z is equal to plus or minus 2J, the imaginary poles. Which one of the following statement is true for signal X of N? Now the options are given. It is a finite duration signal. It is a causal signal. It is a non-causal signal. It is a periodic signal. Now from these options, we can eliminate one or two directly. See, absolutely summable. So what is the meaning of this one? That is, the given x of n is a stable signal, right? That is the meaning of this absolutely summable, that we know. And he mentioned it is a rational function. So whenever it's a rational function, so we can comment on the, what you call, the causal signal. Now it is a causal or non-causal, the only the options are this one. So it is not a finite duration signal, because finite duration signal means the ROC should be mentioned, so enter Z plane or accept something. Now it cannot be periodic signal, right? Because generally the Z transform is for only a periodic signals, so it is not a periodic signals. Now we may apply the for the periodic signals also, but apart according to this question, it is not a periodic signal. So only either B and C, that we can conclude. Now the moment the poles are given plus or minus 2J, now we know that when the Z transform includes unit circle, then only the given signal or system is stable. Now to include the unit circle, what is the ROC? ROC should be mod Z is less than 2J or mod 2J. So then that is mod Z is less than 2. Now we know that for a system or signal is causal means the ROC should be exterior of the outermost pole. But what is the ROC? If it is absolutely summable or stable, we are getting mod Z is less than 2. So mod Z is less than 2 means that is not a exterior of the outermost pole. So it is not allow following the this causal system property. So what is the option? So this is not also correct. The system or signal is the non-causal signal, right? So by looking the question itself, we can observe what is the option, but we will go with like this. Now x of n is a stable signal. That means the when we take x of z, so it will have two zeros and two poles are given, but it is a rational function. So maybe we'll get one more zero or pole, sorry, one more pole, right? So there is a rational function. So one is at z minus 2y, that is z is equal to 2y, and one more is minus 2y. Now to be stable means, so this is like this, so circle will be the same radius. Now to be stable, the ROC should be inside of this circle. So that means it should include the inner circle. So it is a stable signal, but non-causal signal. Yes or no? So I already told causal means it should be exterior of the outermost pole. Now we'll solve one more question. So it is came in gate 2015. So two causal discrete time signals x of n and y of n are related as y of n is equal to summation of the x of n. That is, we need to apply the accumulation property here. The moment we see this equation, so we should apply the accumulation property. Then if the z transform of y of n is given like this, 2y z into z minus 1 whole square, then the value of x of 2. So we need to find the x of n, then from that x of n we can find x of 2. Now how to solve this one? That first we'll take y of z is given, that is 2 by z into z minus 1 whole square, right? Now from this accumulation property, so what this accumulation property tells, that y of z is equal to x of z by 1 minus z inverse. Yes or no? So that is accumulation property. Now y of z is given, then we can find x of z, then we can find the inverse z transform. Y of z is equal to given as 2 by z into z minus 1 whole square, which is equal to x of z by 1 minus z inverse. Now if I take this z outside, so this will become z square, but it will become 1 minus z inverse square. So x of z by 1 minus z inverse is equal to, if I take z into z outside, so it will become z square, and inside it will become 1 minus z inverse square. Why I have taken like that means we should cancel this one, 1 and 1. So what is x of z? So x of z is equal to 2 into z square into z, z cube. If it is going up, so z minus 3 by 1 minus z inverse. Now how to find the inverse z transform of this signal? We know that u of n, what is the z transform? 1 by 1 minus z inverse. So we got 1 by 1 minus z inverse. So to get z power minus 3, what we need to do? Just shifting of the u of n. So what is u of n minus 3? It will become z power minus 3 by 1 minus z inverse. Now to match with this one, just multiply with 2. Now what is the inverse z transform of this signal? Simply x of n is equal to 2 into u of n minus 3. But he did not ask x of n. He asked what is the x of 2 value. Now from this, what is x of 2? Simply 0, because this signal is starting from 3. So something like this, 2 into u of n minus 3 means, so from 3 onwards it will start 2, 4, 2 and so on. So you are from 0, 1 and 2, what is the value? We'll get 0. Right, so this is about this one. So here we are using the accumulation property, right? Next I'll solve this question, that is the value of sigma n is equal to 0 to infinity n into 1 by 2 power n. Now when we do, by doing the summation, so it will be very complex, right? So we will take the help of the z transform. So what is the x of z? X of z is equal to sigma n is equal to minus infinity to infinity x of n into z power minus n. Now which signal will start from 0 to infinity? We know that u of n. So this is coming n equal to 0 to infinity. What is x of n? N into 1 by 2 power n u of n. Then only it will start from 0 to infinity, and it is z power minus n. Now we can eliminate u of n also. Now to compare with this one, this signal and this one, so what we need to make? Suppose if I make z is equal to 1, so this signal will become n is equal to 0 to infinity n into 1 by 2 power n into 1. So this is x of 1. So if z is equal to 1, right, then the signal whatever we getting, so is same as the given signal. So that means if I find, suppose if I take x of n is equal to n into 1 by 2 power n u of n, then if I find x of z, then at z is equal to 1, whatever the value we are getting, that is nothing but the summation of this value, right? Now how to find this x of z? Now first we'll take this one, so 1 by 2 power n u of n. It's very simple, a power n u of n means 1 by 1 minus 1 by 2 z inverse. Now, if we multiply with n here, so n into 1 by 2 power n u of n. So, which property we need to use? That is the differentiation in the z domain. So, that will become minus z into d by dz of 1 by 1 minus 1 by 2 into z inverse. Now, it is looking like 1 by x. So, what is the differentiation of 1 by x? So, I am writing here minus z into minus 1 by x square. That is 1 minus 1 by 2 z inverse whole square. Again, we need to do the differentiation for the x. So, x means it will become 0 minus 1 by 2 into x power minus 1. That means minus 1 into x power minus 2. So, that is this. So, see, minus minus 2 minuses 3 minus 4 minus. So, 4 minuses will become plus. So, z inverse 2. Z inverse 2 into z inverse. So, 1 by 2 z inverse by 1 minus 1 by 2 z inverse square. This is the x of z. But we need at z is equal to 1. So at z is equal to 1, what is x of 1? 1 by 2 into 1 by 1 minus 1 by 2 into 1 whole square. So it will become 1 by 2 by 1 by 4. Right? 1 by 2 whole square means 1 by 4. So what is this? 4 by 2. So it is 2. So what is the value? The summation value is nothing but. So remember, so in the time domain it is some integration is there, we can go for the either Laplace transform or continuous time Fourier transform. If there is a summation, either we go for Z transform or discrete time Fourier transform, right? Next we will solve this question. So again, this is came in GATE 2015. The pole zero diagram of a causal and stable discrete time system is shown in figure. So this is the pole zero pattern is given. See, there is a complex conjugate poles, right? So 0.5 plus 0.5j, 0.5 minus 0.5j. Here, this is minus value, this is plus value. So four poles are complex conjugate as well as, and at the origin, the zeros are there, which is multiplicity of four. So four zeros are at the origin, that is z power four by some value. The impulse response of the system is h of n. If h of zero is equal to one, we can conclude that. So depending on the this pole zero diagram, so we have to comment on h of n is a real value or real signal, purely imaginary or real or only even imaginary for only odd of n. Now the moment we see the pole zero configuration, the poles are complex conjugate. Now we have to see the conjugation property. So what is the conjugation property in the Z transform is, if we do the conjugation for x of n. So what is the z transform? X conjugate of z conjugate. Now there we have discussed some more property, that is if x of n is real. So what is x conjugate of n? Is nothing but x of n. That means the x of z will become equal to x conjugate of z conjugate. So what is this meaning is, when we do conjugation for the x of z and the conjugate signal, so this will be equal to the x of z. That means in the z plane we will have complex conjugate poles. All right, that is, see here, so it is having a pole here, then it is having complex conjugate pole here. So point now, similarly, see here, not here, so these two are complex conjugate, these two are complex conjugate. Yes or no? This is 0.5 plus 0.5 j. So what about this one? 0.5 minus 0.5j. Here also minus 0.5 plus 0.5j. What is the conjugation? Minus 0.5 minus 0.5j. So what is the it is implicating that the x of n is real for all n. So this is the one, right? If we are getting complex conjugate poles, so without any doubt, the signal is given a system or whatever, it is a real signal, right? Next, we will solve this question. So, this question came in GATE 2014. X of z is given like this, 1 by 1 minus 2 into z inverse square with ROC mod z is greater than 2. Then, we need to find the x of 2. Now, how to proceed here is, we need to find the inverse z transform of this signal. Now, when we try to find the inverse z transform, there are two approaches, right? So, partial expansion method, as well as the binomial series, or we can say power series expansion method. Now when we find the power series expansion method, then we can easily find the x of 2. But when we try to go for this partial fraction method, so it will be a lengthy procedure because this is looking like 1 by z x square, right? So it may be in the time domain, discrete domain, that is, it may be multiplication with n, right? So to go for that procedure, it's sort of lengthy procedure. So we will go with the power series expansion method. That is, anyway, mod z is greater than 2 is given, right? So how can I replace the x of z is some simple like this, 1 minus 2 into z inverse power square, and square means the denominator is square, so it will be numerator means minus 2. Now what is the binomial expansion or binomial theorem? So we'll have, suppose 1 plus x inverse, what is the expansion is 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube and so on. Similarly, if it is a 1 minus x minus 2, right, or plus 2, so what is this? It will have 1, see, minus minus means 1 plus 2x plus 3x square plus 4x cube plus 5x power 4 and so on. This is the binomial expansion or binomial theorem for this 1 minus x power minus 2. Condition is mod x should be less than 1 or x is should be less than 1. What is x here? 2 into z inverse less than 1. So it will become 2 mod z. So what is this? Mod z is greater than 2. So anyway, this is given already. Now how can we expand this one? 1 minus x. So 1 minus x power minus 2 means 1 plus 2 into x. So 2 into z inverse plus 3 into x square. So 2 z inverse square plus 4 into 2 into z inverse whole cube and so on. Now how it will be? 1 plus 4 z inverse plus 3 into 2 square means 4, that will become 12 z inverse 2 plus 4 into 2 cube, so 8, so it will become 32 z inverse 3 and so on. Now this is the x of z. Now if I take the inverse z transform, so what we will get? X of n. So whenever 1 is there, so we will get delta n. Whenever z minus 1 is there, we will get 4 into delta n minus 1 plus 2, 12 into delta n minus 2 plus 32 into delta n minus 3 and so on. Now from this, what is the x of 2 value? It's nothing but 12. So what is the value here? We get 12 is the x of 2, right? So this is about some previous gate questions. So you try to solve the remaining gate questions. So if you are not getting, so please post a comment, right? So this is about the Z transform. Then the remaining topics in the signals and systems are, so what are the topics left are? The DFT, discrete time, discrete Fourier transform, discrete Fourier transform. And we have left with the FFT also. So we'll some introduction we'll give for FFT. Similarly, we'll have what we call the filter, digital filter design, right? So these two topics are there. Also one more is the frequency response, that is we have to deal with the phase delay and group delay. So these three topics are very small topics. So what we have to do is, so what are the different digital filters, that is high pass, low pass, band pass, etc. And we have to discuss about the DFT. So looking like this is DTFT, discrete time Fourier transform, right? And we have to see the circular convolution also. And the phase delay and group delay is a simple one. So that we will see in the maybe 2-3 classes it will take, right? And what I do is, I will start the electronic devices and circuits, the EDC course, from today onwards, right? And parallelly I will cover these three topics. Anyway, you think that the signal systems maximum 90% is over, right? We will only left with these three topics. And we continue with these three topics. Maybe it will take 3 lectures, right? Or 3-4 lectures. I will finish with that one. But parallelly, I will start the electronic devices and circuit course, right?